Well, some freaking awesome news. Guess where I am? Well, it'll be a little hard to tell. We're in Mauston right now, and due to some extremely, extremely awesome timing, I am also in Mauston with the guys that are lighting up the Mauston Supercharger. That means we are flipping on today Wisconsin's first supercharger. Now, because it is about 10 degrees out, and my kids are starving, and there's no play place at Culver's. We're at McDonald's. Yeah, I know. But we will be going, they're gonna need about an hour to get some things prepped, and I will be the first well, maybe not the first, because one of their guys drove up from Chicago because they didn't know I was around to test out their system. Barely made it here because it's so freaking cold out. He actually stopped in Rockford first, then came to Wisconsin, shot up from there because it was closer to go from Rockford to the Mauston than it was from Chicago. That way he'd have enough juice. So, in about, they're gonna need an hour. Actually, we can, no, we can't see. They're gonna need about an hour to get that set up. I'll be back there in about 45 minutes. Gonna go take the kids in, get them something to eat, and they'll take some awesome pictures. Lighting up the first Wisconsin supercharger. All right, they're getting final wiring in case anybody wanted to see what the inside one of the suckers looked like. At least the kiosks. As you can probably see, that's some very heavy-duty wire. And to make it more flexible, they split off into two smaller cables for each positive and negative. Awesome. And they got the gate up. Getting all the power running. We'll update you in a few minutes. All right, here we go. First supercharging in Wisconsin.
Are you on? Hold on.
Oh, we got red.
This one is on one, right?
Yeah.
Then we should put this also on one to make maximum charge.
This is one.
Okay.
No. You're at the wrong one.
Which one?
This one.
That should be 1A.
Which one?
Excuse me. That should be 1B right there.
Which one?
This one or the next one?
The next one over. This should be 3.
Do the next one.
Go over one.
You might have. Sorry. That one.
First supercharging in Wisconsin. Red. Oh, no, now it's green.
You're charging.
All right. No. Oh, crap.
Mind if I unplug it?
You gonna plug it?
Uh-oh.
So you gotta listen to it first, right?
Yeah.
You gotta listen to it quick.
What's this, Nash?
Okay. I forgot he's gotta do it. There we go.
There you go, Dutch.
Thank you. Put your hood up. It's cold. Red. Probably didn't get it in fast enough. I'll let you do it. New equipment, might be a little tight.
It's a weird color.
That happened at Rockford with me too. There we go. All right, let's see what we got coming out here. Oh, Vinny, climbed out of your seat. Okay, I don't have room for everybody on my lap at the same time. All right, wrapping up the first Wisconsin supercharging. 20 kilowatts. Leveling off. 59 amps. All right, gotta put the camera down. I'm getting attacked by midgets. Right now, the, is it windy out. Superchargers are in testing phase. They're buttoning up some things on them. Got me going. Good. The one from Chicago. And right now they have it limited to 20 kilowatts to make sure equipment's running properly. We're at 60 amps at 232 volts. 6 kilowatts we've gained. We've only, even at 20 amps, it's right now at 20 kilowatts. This is like having a dual, it's the speed of a dual charger. Let's see, let's change over to distance. And we're charging at 67 miles per hour. At this speed, I should be done in probably about 45 minutes. I didn't have a drained car though to begin with. If I would have known timing and everything would have worked out so well, I wouldn't have done a full charge today. I would have just enough to get here and back home if the supercharger didn't work. And since I came from the Dells today, I would only have needed about 50 miles of charge. Round trip plus a buffer, plus it's freaking cold out. That is a little off the for the temperature, but now the thing I don't like about doing it based on hours, I prefer kilowatts. Miles per hour recharge is an average over the whole charge, whereas charging units of energy tells you instantly what you're getting. So we're at 20 kilowatts right now. Still playing around a little bit. Yes, the Juicy's, yeah, I put the Juicy away so Vinny doesn't throw it. Alright, we'll merge another one into here. Lots of little updates to come. I got probably about a half hour, 45 minutes before I gotta hit the road. All stations are functional. Everything looks good. We are gonna disembark now and let these nice guys over there finish doing their buttoning up. And there you go, Wisconsin's first Tesla superchargers. This day shall go down in history forever. Supercharger! Now leaving the Wisconsin's first supercharger, Mauston, Wisconsin at the Culvers. Successfully did a range charge. We tested all six bays out between me and a Tesla employee with a P85 Plus. And we are roasting up now. We burned as much energy out as we could. Was not expecting anybody to be here today. Was just doing a status update. And there we go. Very nice guys. We'll be seeing a lot of each other. I guess Madison's gonna be the next one up and running. Pleasant Prairie has now, or is in the process of breaking ground. So, looks like we're doing Madison, Pleasant Prairie, followed by Eau Claire, then Onalaska. If I'm even pronouncing that one right. Yeah, there you have it. Not officially open. A little word. Tesla is not going to be doing, due to our Wisconsin climate, a individual supercharging grand opener party for each supercharger. Instead, they are going to be doing one big-ass grand opening party for all of them. No word as to date or location yet. I will keep you guys all informed. There we go, Tesla's Motors Club, just updating you guys. They're there now. I actually had to burn out some extra energy in that P85. And I got a full battery pack and a very happy car right now. And I think this is the warmest my battery's gotten since I supercharged at the Rockford about a month ago. Boy, what a difference when your battery pack gets hot enough for your AC to kick in to cool it. That's when you know your battery's nice and warm. And when it's freaking cold outside, don't pay attention to that temperature gauge on my dash, as I had this car up to about, well, probably close to 100 degrees. At least it felt like 100 in here. So that might be skewed just a little bit, even though that's supposed to be outside and we're sitting in the sun. But it's about 15 out. And what a difference my overall total charge was a lot higher, given a nice hot battery pack. Anyways, that's it. Now, officially, that station is supposed to be going offline today until the official opening, which is when everybody will be receiving an email in this general region. Will receive an email stating that charger is going online. However, they will be doing more tests over the next few weeks until that email goes out and happens. So, if you are driving past, no guarantees that it will be on, but you're welcome to stop by, they said, and plug in. If it's on, it's on. If it's not, you're SOL. You might have to go to Sparta or backtrack by my place in the Dells and top off on my 1450 or the Sparta's J1772, although the 1772 in Sparta is very slow. And that's it. Man, Tesla sure knows how to pick a good group of people to work for them. Even if they are just a couple of them were contractors, the rest were direct employees of Tesla, and just a great group of guys to work for or work with. They're doing their best to get all these superchargers up and running in Wisconsin. And trust me, they are working their backsides royally off to get these superchargers up and running for us. So anybody complaining that they're not going fast enough, cut them some slack. They are doing a great job. Very professional and just excellent. I can't give them enough praise. Tesla, you guys got to raise their salaries up a little bit if you want to ask my opinion. Although, I'm sure they're getting... you guys know what you're doing, but Tesla, great group of guys. Keep employing people like this and you'll keep providing an awesome product like the Model S and you're sure to succeed. And there we go. And I have to thank Tesla for letting and its employees for letting me and my boys to be the... And Vinny. Got Gino. Say hi, Gene. He's sleepy. And he's
Gene.
Got it.
Gene.
Okay.
Gene.
Dean,
for
letting me and my boys be the first in Wisconsin to supercharge ever here. That was much appreciated, and just makes owning a Model S that much more awesome. Can't wait till that Madison, Pleasant Prairie, Eclair, and on Alaska. Although I don't know. I don't think I've ever had to go towards Minneapolis, but definitely can't wait until that Pleasant Prairie's open and Madison's open. But please, please, at least put just one, two supercharging kiosks in the Dells. Everybody, not a single person that I've talked to has said that we should not have one in the Wisconsin Dells. Everybody says put one there. Why is one there? Otherwise, like my previous offer from almost a year ago stands, we have a parking lot at my family's motel, and we're more than happy to host a supercharger for you. In the meantime, our 1450 outlets are ready and available for all to come. Anyways, supercharging, just freaking awesome.